Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we are joined by Manik Sarkar, the Politburo member of the CPIM and the former Chief Minister of Tripura. And we are going to be talking about the situation of COVID-19 as well as both in the state as well as in the country. Thank you so much for joining us. So first of all, my question was regarding the COVID-19 situation in the state itself. So Tripura is one of the states which has been quite severely affected in the region, both in terms of the number of cases as well as in terms of the number of deaths. So could you talk a bit about how the BJP government has been handling the issue? There have been a lot of protests by the left over there on regarding this, regarding the handling of the pandemic as well. So could you talk a bit about how it has been handling the issue?
Initial stage of this COVID-19 attack, the situation of the state was not that bad. But what is the state of affairs nowadays? Total number of positive cases so far found, it has crossed 25,000. And the number of deaths, yesterday night, it has touched 270, I think by this time, number must have increased. From this, you can well imagine the gravity of the situation here in Tripura. That's why I'd like to say, really, really, the COVID-19 situation in Tripura is very, very alarming, worrisome. What you have asked, that how the government of Tripura is handling all these things, I would say very humbly and modestly, right from the beginning, the BJP-led government in Tripura have been taking lackluster attitude towards this problem. At the initial stage, the number of positive cases are very, very limited. No death at the initial stage was there. Perhaps that might have created some self-satisfaction in the mind of the political leadership of the government of Tripura. But we have warned them. This is just starting. How far it will go? What will be the gravity in the coming days? Considering the international situation and national situation and location of Tripura from three sides, it is actually garrowed by international border, particularly Bangladesh, in a large area. And situation in Bangladesh at that point of time was not that good, and now also it is being aggravated, you know. So keeping all these things in our mind, we tried our level best to draw the attention of the government for taking necessary measures so that right from the beginning, they can well tackle it. But I would say it's wrong handling, inept handling of management of this problem. Reasons are many. The doctors, they are the frontline warrior. This very phrase word has been used by our government of India. It's very good. All right. They cannot move on their own without the assistance of nurses, paramedics, and other supporting help. So, it was the demand throughout the country, and also they have earned these experiences, what the other countries in other parts of the world have been taking with regard to the protection of doctors, nurses, paramedics, and other helping hands. And the very popular abbreviation, that is PPE, personal preventive equipments. That was very, very inadequate in Tripura. We have been actually right from the beginning saying, until and unless they are protected and they feel free from any sort of uncertainty, it would not be easy for them to discharge their, I should say, holy responsibilities. But the government of Tripura did not take care of that with that seriousness. Then the most important thing is this. It was actually over-centralized. But right from the beginning, we have been saying, until today we are saying, that it should be decentralized. I would say the infrastructure, health infrastructure, during the left-front government, with all its limitation, tried its level best to decentralize it right from the state capital to the grassroots level, that is Gram Panchayat level. What we have said, don't depend on the tertiary level hospitals located at Agartala, that is the capital town. 8 districts are there, 23 subdivisions, administrative subdivisions are there. So, at the initial stage, we have requested and advised that all the district hospitals should be equipped. Of course, before the breaking out of this pandemic, to take care of all this for test, etc., keeping all this in mind, the lab of those district hospitals are not that actually equipped. So we told them, at a time you cannot, gradually you please try to strengthen the district level hospitals, and then you come down to subdivision level hospitals, then PHC. Of course, in PHC, this sort of lab development is not that easy. And we have not asked for that also at the initial stage. But that was not properly heeded too. Cursory comment, yes, we are thinking of. But I should say, did fail to take care of this very particular aspect. Then most important thing was this, more than 44,000 people, they have been migrated to other states of our country. Most of them, they actually deserted the state in search of work and food. Apart from them, some other people are there for treatment, for examination, for visiting different areas, education, etc., all these things, or going to meet their relatives. That number may not be that many, but most of the number among these 44,000, this number actually has been provided by the state government itself, BJP-led government. So, yes, there was a hue and cry. All on a sudden, within the gap of 4 hours, this lockdown throughout the country, that created a lot of problem, like demonetization, like your one country, one nation, one tax. That has created a lot of problem. We know all these things. So this time also, only with the gap of 4 hours, this actually lockdown has started taking place. So these people throughout the country, they were quite at a loss how they have come to their place of residence. So in this situation in Tripura also, we asked the government, because this is actually surrounded by the international border. Two thick countries are there. Then people are coming by rail, by road, by airport, air, etc., all these things. We requested that these migrants, when they will start returning back, they should be taken in the hands of the government and first start test, identify the positive cases. Instead of doing that, out of 5, they are testing 1. That actually created mess. Doctors, more than 30 doctors have been actually attacked because of positive. Nurses, good number of nurses, paramedics, and people who are involved in cleaning activities in the hospital, security personnel, good number of them they also have been attacked. Number is not being disclosed by the state government. And some of our doctors, very good, good doctors, they have been forced to take shelter in their own residence, and one or two of our doctors have been sent to other state for their better treatment. That is the situation. Please, you can try to understand what is going on. Root cause, another cause is this, that the government has failed to take the doctors into confidence.
Right.
Particularly the senior doctors, experienced doctors, who are available in our state and working in the hospitals, particularly in the tertiary hospitals. And they should have been given free hands so that they can devote themselves to take care of the patients. Interventions were there. And not only free hand, they need all sorts of assistance from the government, not only financial, from the administrative side also, but that was not given. So all these actually have created lot of problems.
So in this context, I also wanted to ask about the CPIM and the left front itself in Tripura. Has there been any regaining of the ground that was lost? What has been the people's response to the issues raised by you? And how do you see the way forward for the left in Tripura, but also maybe at a national level itself?
First of all, in Tripura, braving all odds, attacks, psychological, physical, administrative, keeping police unmoved, I should say. Police cannot be blamed. They are actually played in the hands of the ruling clique as pawn. Some of them perhaps tried to take some initiative in an independent manner. They have to face for all these things. So, in this situation, for democracy, for food, for job, before pandemic, CPIM and left, they came down on the street, started raising all these slogans, all these demands, put forth before the government, inside the assembly, outside the assembly, mobilization were going on, attacks were there, threats were there, but all these things could not stop left to move, stop CPIM to move. During this COVID pandemic, after formal withdrawal of lockdown, again, with the CPIM and the left have started coming on the streets. At the national level, what I have already mentioned, the burning demands to take care of the daily wage earners, peasantry, workers, working people, unemployed, we have been raising all these things. What we have been experiencing started getting response from the common people. Among them, a section who deserted us again started returning back. I am telling you, in the center, BJP-led government. In the state, BJP-led government. Span only 30 months. In this situation, when they are threatening that we have come to stay for a long, long time, it may be 25, 30, 40 years. But in this situation, those who were the BJP flag bearers, poor people, semi-middle class, at this stage, they have started deserting them, taking red flag in their hands, and openly declaring, we have committed mistake. Now it is clear to us, there is no alternative to left. Now we again mobilize ourselves on the platform of left, and it has to be strengthened. What may come? It's a very encouraging thing. Within a very short span of time, So their limited experiences, they have realized this is not the government has come to work for the people. This is the government of the rich people. They are the looters. They are against the poor people, against the common people. So this is one. And on the other hand, if this is the reaction and observation, it might have other reaction, other picture. What is that? BJP has started losing their ground, supporting base. They have started realizing all these things. That's why they are trying to concentrate on fascistic attack, attack on democracy. We know this may come, but the people of Tripura, we are trying to rouse their braving voice. To face it, unite yourself, bring new people with you, go ahead. Otherwise, you will not be in a position to survive. Your back is actually just dashed to the wall. There is no space further to go back. Now you have to proceed further. There is no other alternative. So they are getting gradually isolated. So they have no other alternative but to resort to further attack. Yes, people are getting them prepared to face all these things. Mm-hmm. Yesterday also, this sort of thing happened. Our tribal friends, under the leadership of Ganamukti Parishad, they organized demonstration to submit their memorandum. They were attacked in one area. The other area of people, those who came to attack them, they resisted them unitedly. They left the area, leaving their motorbikes. Then police came for their rescue. This is what is going to happen. We are not telling people. Right. Take arms in your hands, lattice in your hands. Only you are telling people, you protect yourself. So people will decide what measures they will adopt to protect themselves and face themselves. So government should realize all these things. This is what they are trying to do. That will not ultimately allow them to go in an unending length. I'm telling you. So about the national situation, what you have said, that how the left at the national level and in Tripura should go forward. I must say, not for Tripura alone. Tripura is part and parcel of India. Struggle of the masses. United masses struggle. There is no other option. Why I am saying so? During this pandemic, you see, RSS dictated BJP-led government at the center. They have been adopting one after another anti-people, disastrous economic policies for the benefit of monopoly capital, corporate houses, both for India and abroad. Overnight, they are working for them. They are not in a position and mood to listen to people. Getting day by day very, very aggrieved. Riding roughshod. What the country, the world has observed in the last parliament session, small session, what they did in the Rajya Sabha. I don't like to narrate all these things. Throttling the democracy. Parliamentary democracy is the root of our Indian democracy after independence. That is under attack. It's a very bad situation. Economic situation. Pre-pandemic, that was just on the verge of economic recession. Now it has aggravated. Now it is grasped. Some people are theoretically says, yes, not yet recession. I don't agree with them. I may not be economist. But where is demand? If you have no work, if you have no money, if you have no purchasing capacity, you cannot go to market. Demand is falling down. If demand is falling down, supply quotient does not come. Economics, most important point is demand and supply. On this, it is a revolving point. everything is actually revolving around. That is coming down. And our GDP first quarter, it is minus 23. I think in the history of independence India, this first time this sort of thing actually has happened. It will again aggravate it, the way they are moving. So to stop the resistance of people, struggle of people, stop raising their demands, what they're doing? Trying to divide the people. Raising the caste question, the religious question, and targeting the minority, particularly the Muslim minority. A very bad thing. That means they are indirectly attacking the constitution of India, secular principles of our country. Democracy, the main thing is equal rights to all. And acid test is, what is the state of affairs of the minorities of a country? If they are actually enjoying all rights, then you can say, yes, democracy is there. But the minorities, particularly the Muslim minorities, this is second largest in the world, next to Indonesia, even higher than Pakistan and Bangladesh, they are being attacked like anything. What is going on? What happened to Delhi? What sort of charge sheets they are making one after another? Who are being targeted? You know better than me. I am in distant corner of the country, but I have been observing all these things. Very, very bad situation. What they are doing? Attacking thoroughly right and left democracy. And now attacking our constitution. I am not detailing all these things. They are thinking of rewriting. Rewrite our history. New culture they are trying to inculcate to our children. Those who cannot differ. Their mother and aunt. They are trying to inculcate new culture. Their culture. So-called Hindutva culture. Fascistic culture. They have learned it from Mussolini. Then Hitler. If you read their literature, you'll find all these things. Mussolini is still their master. That way, they are shaping their RSS. So, main target is this. So, in this situation, what I'm telling, you see, not the left alone. Yes. Left, whatever strength they have, equally not strong in each and every state. In some states, we have strength. We may not win election, but we can mobilize people. People are there to listen us. So those states, and we should try our level best to strengthen the left unity. And pose the alternative to all this in a pragmatic manner. Don't say socialism at this moment, but against the capitalist system. That is in crisis. That's why they are attacking democracy, taking autocratic steps, taking this fascistic measures. This is the sign of ugly crisis of capitalist economy. So in this situation, it has to be destroyed. Alternative, socialism, there is no other alternative. It is not a matter of dream. It has to come because you have to change the relation between the productive force and productive relation. This method, this mode should be changed. So all this cannot be brought until and unless ousting capital system from the state power and bringing the socialist system. I don't like to detail all these things, but at this moment, from the pragmatic point of view, the demands you should raise, which you head on at one point of time, even during British rule, through a ceaseless struggle, those are being snatched one after another. That should be stopped and prevented, and try your level best to get back all these things. Economic demands, trade union rights. So in this situation, left shall have to take special initiative to mobilize working class, working people, peasantry, and agricultural workers. They are the village proletariat. So if unity between them is developed and it is solid, then they will be able to draw the attention of the other sections of people, the semi-middle class, middle class. So this will be the core. So left has to take this initiative. But left should not close their eyes. They shall have to open their eyes and try to mobilize other non-left, non-BJP political parties. They may not agree with the left on all questions. It cannot be. But that might be a limited space, limited demands on democracy, on also some economic aspects. Wherever there is agreement, broadest possible unity of left and other democratic forces, they should force and they should unleash ceaseless struggle.
Right.
It is not monsoonal, I would say, in a humble manner. Ceaseless struggle is necessary. And what I have said already, alternative should be projected. Only just to return back, get back the snatched demand, that will not suffice. Need alternative. And internationally, now people have started thinking all these things. Socialist countries, they have shown their mettle in tackling this COVID pandemic and also consolidating their economic situation, even in this crisis. Alternative they have shown. And non-socialist countries too, even in USA, people have started thinking in different way.
Right.
This capitalism, imperialism, and adopting fascistic measure, this is the ugly face of capitalist system, will not take care of the problem. People have to start thinking afresh, start for thinking alternative.
Thank you so much for talking to us and giving us information as well as perspectives on the way forward. And that's all we have time for today. Keep watching Newsclick. Thank you.